Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 72. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Problem 72. We have x over x plus 2 minus 3 over x minus 2, and we want to see which one of the four following options it matches up with. So it's unfortunate that the denominators are not the same. They're almost the same. If they were both over x plus 2 or both over x minus 2, the problem would be super easy. You just combine the tops. But there's some work to do to make the denominators the same. So the common denominator will be one denominator times the other denominator. It's going to be x plus 2 times x minus 2. That's what we have to turn both denominators into. Then we can combine the numerators. So the first fraction that's over x plus 2, I am going to multiply times x minus 2. But if I do it in the denominator, I have to do it in the numerator also. So basically, that first fraction is getting multiplied times a funny looking 1. X minus 2 over x minus 2 will reduce to 1 no matter what x is. Now the second fraction that has an x minus 2 as the denominator, I'm going to multiply that times x plus 2 over x plus 2. Again, I'm multiplying times essentially what's a funny looking 1. By multiplying times 1, I'm not going to change its value. I'm just going to change the way it looks. So let's go ahead and do those multiplications. So in the numerator of the first fraction, I'm going to have x times x, which is x squared. X times negative 2 is minus 2x. And the denominator will be x minus 2 times x plus 2. Now, the other fraction I'm going to have, notice the 3 here is negative. So negative 3 times x will be negative 3x. And then negative 3 times 2 is negative 6. And same denominator, x minus 2 times x plus 2. Now that I have the same denominators, I can combine the numerators. So my common denominator is x minus 2 times x plus 2. Now when I combine the numerators, let's see, I have an x squared and no other x squared. So x squared will come over by itself. Then I have a negative 2x and a negative 3x. I can combine those and make a negative 5x. And then minus 6, there are no other regular numbers to combine it with. So now as I look at my list of options, the denominator actually has been multiplied out. It's a difference of squares. So I can leave the top x squared minus 5x minus 6. And the bottom, if you do out your difference of squares, you will get x squared minus 4. Now, as I look, a lot of these look so similar, but the top one, if you pay attention to everything, x squared minus 5x minus 6 over x squared minus 4 is a perfect match for the answer I got. So the answer to this problem is option A.